Hey YouTubers, welcome back for another adventure, and you're probably going to be seeing a lot of this thing. This is a tailor done, what's called a burden carrier, burden carrier I think is what it's called. It was bought in New York City at an auction, and if you just take a quick look, you can see it's got 2,700 hours on it. And it was known as 40562, and the auction number was 139. So that's what it looks like from the front. Kind of a cool look, huh? It's got the old roll bar on it, which is a good thing. It's got this bed on it, obviously, but imagine if you shortened it, right? Two people could sit there, and if you shortened it again, right, two people could actually sit there. So, I mean, that's interesting. The stake bed is extra. And speaking of which, I was trying to see how this flipped up, and it turns out you just lift the plywood out of the way. It actually moves from the other side a little easier. So that's it in all its glory. See the battery and so forth. Now, I bought this or traded it sight unseen. And the person who got the tug ended up with that sight unseen. Though, you know, I told him what he was getting, and he told me what I was getting. Now, it looks like a Kohler engine. Yeah, I think it says Kohler there. Looks like a good size Kohler engine, like a 10 or a 12 horse. And you guys could see the rear axle there. And if I zoom in, could you see the problem with the rear axle? That line is not a good thing. That's not supposed to be there. Now, what I was told is it ran. It smoked a little bit, but it's currently over full of oil. But you guys know I'm not a person that's concerned about smoke. It ran fine. And the guy was driving it, and he said he high-grounded it and cracked the case there. I'm kind of looking at it, and the way that cross member goes by and so forth, and then you have the axle there. I'm not sure if he cracked the case, if the case was already cracked, and then when he high grounded it, it just kind of got finished off. I love the bees. He led me to believe that it was running, and from the smell of the gasoline, I didn't actually touch gasoline, but just by putting my finger in there and taking it right out, the gasoline seems to smell okay. These are the other markings on it. So now you guys know about as much of it about it as I do. It did come with the key, and it came with a flat tire. But these tires actually look pretty new. So I'm hoping that I can pump that up and bring it back to life. These come off. Now, he said he saw a plate somewhere. I haven't seen the plate yet. But he said he saw a plate somewhere that says this thing weighs 1,200 pounds. And quite honestly, looking at its construction, I believe it weighs all of that. Every bit of that 1,200 pounds. I'm trying to get it in the picture for the money shot later. So that's, now you guys know everything I know about it. Let's see. Oh, look at that. Yeah, let's take a look under the other one. Oh, it seems to have safety on the seat. Guess it might want you to sit down before it lets the starter engage or anything. We'll have to bypass those. Oh, here we go. So, maybe that's better. Trying to not cast a shadow on it, but at the same time, trying to look through the camera. There you go. So it says the gross weight is 1,298, rated capacity 1,500 pounds. It says, say it's got a contract holder, but B610. So that might where he got the burden carrier. I think it was burden carrier. He referred to it as a burden carrier. So about that rear end, I'm hoping that a golf cart rear end fits in here. It's got a relatively short wheelbase, so that means you put a lot, if you load it up well, right? If you put the weight basically in the front of the back tire, you'll be putting quite a bit of the weight on the front tire. Or if you put a bunch of weight in front of the back tire, you'll actually be putting a lot of that weight on the front tires. It looks, it started out orange and it was painted red. Anyhow, from this video, I'm going to do some research. The first thing I'm going to do before I poke around with that rear axle or anything, I am going to get that back, fix that back tire, whatever it needs. Hopefully, I'll be able to just glue it onto the rim and that'll fix it. If that doesn't do it, hopefully your tube will fix it because the sidewall's not blown out. And I got to look around the hoard to see if I have a spare. Just to get things rolling. This thing, it's like a gigantic wet turd. It's not going to roll, right? It's just stuck to the ground right where it sits until I get a tire on the back of it there. So, I mean, it's interesting. They wrote this 139 all over the place. Every once in a while, if you type auction and 139, you'll get something on the internet. You know, Google will find it, that it was actually in an auction and 139 is the cart, and they'll actually give you some details. Sometimes that works. Sometimes if you put in this number, you'll find out that it's on a public database, or it was involved in a lawsuit. So, you know, Taylor Dunn and that number, and you might find out it was in a lawsuit and somebody specifically mentioned it. So it never hurts to, when you see some numbers and so forth, is to Google them in all ways, manners, and forms to see what pops up. There is this tie here that they used for something. Yeah, sometimes you can find a tool left behind, shoved under the seat, or some other markings. I really haven't gone through it anymore. I've done more looking at it through this video than I have before. Yeah, it seems to steer fine. It rolled somewhat, even with the flat tire. So, let's hope for the best. He set the emergency brake. I was kind of laughing. I'm like, yeah, with that flat tire, this thing isn't going anywhere. And by the way, about the emergency brake, if you set it, it could get stuck. Either the brake's up high and tight or it's seized. So once again, this is all I know about it. I'm sure some of you guys who've worked in factories or, you know, for various utilities or in warehouse type situations or someplace with a big yard, you guys rode around these all the time. Taylor Dunn, I know, makes some pretty good stuff. So I look forward to getting this running. It'll be another toy to play with. Typically these things in functional condition, they go for somewhere around $2,500 by me, with the gas motor and all that. So you guys might say, why did you get rid of the tug? I really wasn't using the tug, which was strike one on it. Strike two, even if I did use it, I only used it in the winter time because the thing weighed 5,000 pounds and it liked to get stuck. I mean, those tires used to just push right through the dirt and get stuck. It was good on blacktop, but I can only amuse myself so many times driving up and down the driveway. So strike one, I rarely used it. Strike two, I only used it during the winter. And strike three, it wasn't aging well. I was afraid that one day I'd go out there and mice will have built something in the engine, or, you know, the tires went flat and I wouldn't be able to get those split rims apart and get the rings on them. Or if I did get them apart and get the new tires on them, as I'm putting air in them, they might lose a ring. You know, they were just everything about it. It was time for it to move on. It needed a new home. And now it has one. Somebody who buys that, who has a parking lot, a small parking lot that they need to keep clear, it is a wonderful thing because it runs on propane. It always seems to start in the coldest of weather. If you have it so that, you know, you only have to lift the plow up an inch, back it up, drop it, and go forward on blacktop, especially if you put chains on there and you're running single wheels, not dualies, that thing will plow blacktop all day long. You'll have no issue with it. But for my situation here, if it's soft and I run one tire off, it was always getting stuck. One time I was plowing this way and the plow went down that little embankment area and hung up, and I lifted it, and then when you lift it, it kind of takes a bunch of the weight off the back wheels, and I couldn't get it loose for anything. I had to use the backhoe loader and call friends over. It was a bit of a turkey. Under perfect conditions, it was great, like plowing straight up, back up, plow straight up again. It was wonderful for that kind of stuff. Especially, I used to keep it over there, so with the blade turned such it was pushing snow that way, I would come off of there and go right up, and then back up, redirect the blade so it would push snow this way. You know, I'd turn it around and do a couple of strikes this way, and it was wonderful for that kind of stuff. But it was 5,000 pounds of trouble to use, you know, a half a dozen times a year. I think I'll make much more better use of this. This will be more fun. I can get a second piece of plywood here and set this up so I can take people for rides on it. This will just be a much more used vehicle. Anyway, I really want to thank everybody for dropping by to watch, comment, and subscribe. Please remember to keep your feet down, your heads up, and get out and enjoy each and every day. Go save a Taylor Dunn from the junkyard somewhere. Bye now.